Hey guys, welcome back. This week we're talking about fiber. And in the previous lesson, we talked about what fiber is, how you get it, and most importantly, the awesome health benefits that come from meeting your body's fiber requirements on a consistent basis. Well, today we're going to talk about similar things, but we're going to delve a little bit deeper into some pretty much, you know, not well-known areas of fiber. And what I mean by that is that there's a lot of lies going on grocery store shelves which trick you into buying products because you believe they're higher in fiber, when in reality, they're really not, and those products really aren't doing much to improve your health. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at that today. But before we begin, I want to show you your food logs. And this is something you all know very well. But the thing that I want to point out is up at the top, I show you the calories, protein, fiber, and sodium content of all the foods that you add to the journal. And then at the bottom, you can always find more information with all the other nutrients. But I believe these four nutrients are the keys to long-term weight management success, helping you feel fuller longer and improving your health. So when you know these four components in every food that you add, add it all up into each meal total, you have a recipe for really cleaning up your diet. The calories is up there. It shows you how many calories is in each food. You can manage your calorie budget that way. The protein's there to help balance all the food combinations that you have together and to make sure that you get enough protein in each of your meals and snacks. The fiber is up there because it instantly tells you whether or not you're eating enough raw whole foods. Because if your fiber content is low in each meal and snack, it means that you're eating too many processed foods from packages, boxes, cans, those kinds of things, and not enough raw foods. And the sodium's there to kind of confirm that. And if you're getting way too much sodium in each meal and snack, it means that you're not eating enough whole raw foods. So all four of those combined to tell you a very important, or give you very important information about each meal and snack so that you can make those meals and snacks much healthier. Now, let's take a look at a food label. Every single food label that you guys consult will always show you how many grams of dietary fiber that food product contains. So the first thing we always do, like always, we're going to look to see the serving size and how many servings that product contains, and then how many calories you're dealing with. So this is a bread product. So in one slice of bread, you're getting 100 calories and 6 grams of dietary fiber. So what you're probably sitting there saying, wow, Joe, what bread is this giving me 6 grams of dietary fiber? And basically what I'm telling you is that anything that's too good to be true most likely is. And like anything else, any other food label, you always must consult the ingredients list to find out what's all in there. And in fact, what you're about to learn is that food companies add what's called fake fiber to their products to boost that dietary fiber number right there, which most people will never realize exists until now. You guys are going to know that this product, as I'm telling you, contains fake fiber. And here's how you find out. Again, you must always look to the ingredients list. Somewhere in this ingredients list, fake fiber resides. And this is what you need to look out for. There's three ingredients that you will find commonly found in products that boost a higher fiber amounts compared to regular versions of that product. And you're looking for these words: inulin, maltodextrin, and polydextrose. If any one of these three fibers are in a food product's ingredients list, that food product is adding fake fiber and you are getting no nutritional benefit whatsoever from that fiber. So basically, here's what's going on. These ingredients are called isolated fibers. And they do indeed help boost the fiber content of food products. But, and here's a huge but, they do not give your body the same health benefits that regular dietary fiber does. All right, that's important to understand. Intact fibers, those that are found in actual fruits, vegetables, whole grains, beans, and nuts, are the good kinds of fiber that your body needs. So the intact fiber that you get from those products is the fiber that promotes health and gives you those benefits that we learned about in the last lesson. The isolated fibers, those that come from inulin, maltodextrin, and polydextrose, are fibers that do absolutely nothing for your health. Now, they don't necessarily harm your health unless you take them in large quantities, but they don't provide those health benefits that the fibers found intact mainly do from fruits, vegetables, whole grains, beans, nuts, and seeds, and those things do. So here's a couple things you got to watch out for. Any label claims out there boasting high fiber, great source of fiber, higher in fiber, whatever, all right? If you see on the front of a package anything about the fiber content of that food, you are in for a real treat whenever you turn the ingredients list over, because what you're going to find is, I would say 99% of the time, you're going to find those three ingredients that I just told you about. So you should always assume that products who use claims like those found on the front of the packages, just like you're seeing there, high fiber, great source of fiber, high in fiber, whatever, boasting about their fiber intake, that they're using fake fiber in their products. And you must always check the ingredients list to see if the product really does contain the fake fiber or the intact fiber. So that's something you always got to do, just like if you're trying to find out if a food product has trans fats in it, artificial sweeteners, and other products that we're looking to avoid or eliminate. So let's take a look at this nutrition facts panel again. And again, you're seeing that this product contains 6 grams of dietary fiber, way too good to be true. So where are we getting that fake fiber from then? And you'll see that actually the third ingredient is inulin, and that's why this fiber content of this bread is so high. Now, a couple things to pay attention to here. You'll notice that this product is actually made with whole wheat flour as well, okay? It's a 100% whole grain product. So you can assume that there's at least 2 to 3 grams of dietary fiber that you're getting from that whole wheat flour included in this, and that the other 2 to 3 or 4 grams of this is that fake fiber stuff. And all they're doing is they're boosting the fiber intake of this so that you see, wow, 6 grams of dietary fiber, I'm buying this bread. When in actuality, all you're doing is kind of lying to yourself and me unintentionally in your food logs, because you're eating breads that have a lot more fiber than a regular slice of bread does, but that's not doing anything for your health. So you're getting fooled into thinking you're meeting your body's fiber requirements when in reality you're not. So you really got to pay attention to this, guys, and make sure that whenever you are buying food products that it's containing the whole wheat part and not any added fiber, fake fiber stuff. So you'd be much better off and doing your body more justice and mentally doing your body justice if you would buy products that don't boost all this high fiber garbage and adding all this fake stuff in and conning yourself into thinking that you're meeting your body's fiber requirements. Let's take a look one more time at something here, and I'm going to bring this Nutrition Day's worth of food up again. And I want you to notice something. Okay, let's look at the fiber content. You can see going down through here, okay, pretty reasonable amounts of fiber. You come down here, orange 3, yeah, banana bread, a little dessertish there, half of that's a fiber. But then here, yogurt. Yoplait Fiber 1, all varieties, 4-ounce container, has 5 grams of dietary fiber. So ask yourself a very easy common sense question. Is yogurt supposed to contain any fiber? The answer to that should be a very big no. Yogurt is a dairy product. Dairy products are supposed to have 0 grams of fiber. But Fiber One makes its claim, and a lot of the, I'm not just picking on Fiber One either, okay? And I don't mean to downplay any products whatsoever, because as you guys know, you can have whatever you want to have in your dietary budgets. It's just you need to be conscious that you don't get too much of those bad things. So in other words, nothing's off limits. If you want to have a piece of cheesecake, by all means, have a piece of cheesecake. But make it work in your calorie budget and don't have it too often, and it's fine. All right, so nothing wrong with this Yoplait Fiber One yogurt either. But what you're setting yourself up for here is thinking that you're actually getting 5 grams of fiber from a product that's not supposed to contain it. And if you would go into the ingredients list, you would easily find that, again, this product is using either inulin, polydextrose, or maltodextrin in their products to boost the fiber intake, and it does nothing for your health. You're actually shorting yourself 5 grams of fiber here when you think that you're actually getting those. So the point is, always look to the ingredients list to find out if what you're eating is actually real fiber or fake fiber, okay? And a couple other key points to wrap up this fiber lesson. Fiber, again, is essential to your health. You will improve your internal health when you meet your body's fiber requirements on a daily basis. So I hope you guys learned something, and I look forward to seeing everybody improving their fiber intake moving forward into the program. I'll talk to you guys again next time. Bye-bye.